Hello students. So in the last class we had started with opportunity cost, economic cost and accounting cost, in which I had explained you with explicit costs and implicit costs. What does it refer to? What is the actual cost? What are the pocket expenditures of the firm and all those things. Now in this class I shall be starting with opportunity cost. Now what do you mean by opportunity cost? Opportunity cost is the cost which is not actually incurred but would have been incurred in the absence of employment of self-owned factors. The concept of opportunity cost was popularized by American writers. It occupies a very important place in modern economic analysis. Opportunity cost of any input is the next best alternative use that is sacrificed by its present use. It is measured by the value of the factors of production used in producing a good when put to the next best alternative use. So what do you mean by opportunity cost? Opportunity cost is not actually a cost which is incurred. In case if you would have not started your business and you would have in case worked or had a job, so in that case how much income you would have generated, this is an opportunity cost. This is not an actual cost, but we assume that in case this had happened, so what would be the cost or what would be the rate of income. So now let us try to understand. In other words, it indicates what a factor would earn in the next best use. Opportunity cost reflects the benefits we give up to select the most preferred choice. For example, if a farmer decides to grow wheat instead of rice, the opportunity cost of the wheat would be the rice which he might have grown rather. Thus, opportunity cost is the cost of foregone alternative if we produce more one thing. Resources have to be withdrawn from the other users as these are scarce. In other words, the opportunity cost of using any factor is what is currently foregone by using it. Opportunity cost is also the opportunity lost or sacrificed to quote Watson, cost of anything is a value of the alternative or the opportunity that is sacrificed. So what is opportunity cost? Is the opportunity lost or sacrificed to do something else. So cost of anything is the value of the alternative or the opportunity that is sacrificed. Implicit cost incurred by the firm is actually the opportunity cost of the factor owned by him. By employing this factor in the firm, the producer loses the opportunity to earn the factor income had it been employed elsewhere. Thus, the opportunity cost of a factor input is nothing but a potential return from the next best alternative use of that factor. So, implicit cost is that cost which is incurred by a firm and is actually the opportunity cost of the factors owned by him. By employing this factor in the firm, the producer loses the opportunity of earning something else in that case. Thus, the opportunity cost of a factor input is nothing but a potential return from the next best alternative use of the factor. Opportunity cost is also the minimum price necessary to retain a factor in the current employment. John Robinson calls it transfer earning. Since a firm has to pay to owners of factors what they can secure in alternative employment, opportunity cost is also known as alternative cost. Opportunity cost of a good is not simply any other alternative good that could be produced with the same factors. It is also the most valuable or the next best alternative good which the same factors or nearly the same value of efforts can produce. So, example, if I start my own business and if I do a job, so in my own business I would have certain risk, but when it comes to someone working with someone else, the risk compared to the own business is little less. So now let us understand about the significance of the concept of opportunity cost. Now why we are studying opportunity cost? The cost of opportunity, the concept of opportunity cost is highly useful to each and every economic unit. Each cost concept can be expressed in terms of opportunity cost. Every action that we take involves an opportunity cost, as cost of getting something involves losing something else. For example, for a student, the cost of seeing a movie may be the book whose purchase he has. For the customer, the opportunity cost of buying a commodity is the price he pays for in monetary terms. So for a student, seeing a movie over buying a book may be foregone. So for watching a movie, maybe he has not taken a book, so he has lost that opportunity of buying the book. Then for the customer, the opportunity cost of buying a commodity is the price he pays for it in monetary terms. So if a customer is buying certain goods, and if in case he doesn't buy those goods, then in that case the commodity is the opportunity cost, that is the monetary amount which he is paying, is his is his opportunity cost. For the government, the cost of building a college may be the hospital sacrifice. So in case if government decides to build a college building, and in case they then feel that instead of paying the cost of building for a college, they might have done a hospital, so the hospital cost gets sacrificed. Then for the society, the cost of setting up an ammunition factory may be the bread and butter sacrifice. So for the society, the cost of setting up an ammunition means what? The ammunition factory, that is the bread butter is sacrificed. Then next is opportunity cost has wide economic implications. It is important in the context of factors of production. As supply of the factors is limited, a factor can be utilized in one use, or at present, by sacrificing its use for other purposes in future. It helps us to know how limited resources gets allocated in different branches of production. So opportunity cost has wide economic implications. It is important that the factors of production have a limited use, and it can be used in different purposes. So for sacrificing its one use, the other gets opportunity cost. It can be used to determine the factor price. The concept is especially relevant for an industry which must pay wages which are at least equal to what are being paid in other industries. Otherwise, labor will shift to another industry. Thus, the opportunity cost in short-term decisions like sales strategy, inventory management, hiring and firing of labor, etc. It is also applicable in investment planning to make a choice of best alternative after evaluating all available alternatives carefully. A profit-oriented firm must consider opportunity cost beside explicit costs in order to use all the resources most economically. So it is applicable that investment planning to make a choice of best alternative after evaluating all the available alternatives. So after you choosing all the alternatives, out of that the product which gives lowest cost but earns higher return is the opportunity cost. So it can be also done in case of labor. So in labor, sometimes we have to hire a labor who is paid higher amount. What is the reason behind paying higher? Because we know that person is capable of doing more work. So this is another opportunity cost. Now next we'll see limitations of the concept of opportunity cost. It is only applicable to those factors which have alternative uses. Thus, if no sacrifice is involved, then the opportunity cost is zero. Even though the actual cost or acquisition cost or the historical cost, the cost at which the factor was originally acquired or purchased was substantial. Further, foregone alternatives are often not clearly ascertainable due to imperfect knowledge of factor owners and imperfections in the market. So it is only applicable to those factors which have alternative uses and there is no sacrifice involved in the opportunity cost, and the opportunity cost is zero. So it is better to not to have alternative uses. Then foregone alternatives are often not clearly ascertainable due to imperfect knowledge of factor. So these costs are even not perfect. Next, behavior of cost curves. Now let us start with the next concept, behavior of cost curves. A firm's cost functions will vary depending on whether they are based on the short run period or long run period. Here, period or time refers to the functional or operational time period. Short run and long run do not refer to any calendar time. They are sets of conditions and not periods of time. A short run period is one during which certain factors like factory buildings, number of machines, land, managerial staff, etc. remain fixed. Hence, these factors are called fixed factors. So, in the short run period, the size of the plant of a firm and its scale of production would remain constant. However, in the short run, the other factors such as labor, raw materials and power can be varied in amount. Hence, these factors are called variable factors. So, in cost curves, we will be seeing firstly short run and long run period. Then, in that we will be seeing what are fixed factors, what are variable factors. Fixed factors are those factors which are fixed to be used, that is number of machines to be used, the building, the machines which are to be used, managerial staff, land, everything is going to remain same. Variable factors means those factors in which labor, raw material, power, all these can be varied according to the production. Then what is a long run period? A long run period is one during which all the factors of production can be fully varied in amount by a firm. That is, in the long run, all the factors will become variable. So, in the long run, the size of the plant of a firm and its scale of production can be fully increased or decreased. So, this was about long run period. Now, let us give about short run cost. Now, what are short run costs? Let us try to understand these concepts. The fixed costs are those costs which are independent of output, that is, they do not change with changes in output. These costs are a fixed amount which must be incurred by a firm in the short run, whether the output is small or large. Even if the firm closes down for some time in the short run but remains in the business, these costs have been borne by it. Fixed costs are also known as sunk costs or indirect costs by economists as overhead costs or supplemented costs by business people. So total fixed costs, not TFC. What is total fixed cost? Total fixed costs are those costs which are, whether it is a short run, whether it is a long run, these costs shall be applicable. And fixed costs are also known as sunk costs or indirect costs or overhead costs or supplementary costs. So people are... People use different wordings, but they all mean the same. These include charges such as contractual rent, insurance fee, maintenance cost, property rent, property taxes, interest on capital invested, minimum administrative expenses such as manager's salary, watchman's wages, etc. Thus, fixed costs are those which are incurred in hiring or the fixed factors of production whose amount can be altered in the short run. So, these are certain costs which include such as contractual rent, then insurance fee, maintenance cost, property taxes, interest on capital invested, minimum administrative expenses. These are certain things which are used. Then next we have total variable cost. Variable costs, on the other hand, are those costs which are incurred on employment of variable factors of production. Production whose amount can be altered in the short run. Thus, the TVCs change with costs with changes in the output in short run. That is, they increase or decrease when the output rises or falls. These costs include payments such as wages of labor employed, prices of raw material, fuel and power used, the expenses on transport, etc. If a firm shuts down production for some time in the short run, then it will not be used the variable factors of production and will not therefore incur any variable costs. Variable costs are made only when some amount of output is produced and the TVCs increase with the increase in the level of production. Variable costs are also called as prime costs or direct costs. So now let us understand about total variable cost. Now what do you mean by total variable cost? Variable costs of production are those costs which are altered in the short run, and these change with the changes in the output in the short run. That is, they increase or decrease when the wages output rises or falls. These costs include payments such as wages of labor employed, prices of raw material, fuel and power used, and the expenses which are incurred on different transport system and other such facilities. So if a firm shuts down its production for some time in the short run, then variable factors shall not be used, but fixed factors shall always be used. So this is also called as prime cost or direct cost. Now let us understand about total cost. Now what is total cost? Total cost of a business is the sum of its total fixed costs and total variable costs. TC is equal to TFC plus TVC. TC increases as level of output increases. So cost is output relationship in short run. Now consider the following table. Now let us try to understand this table with the explanation. So see, in the first column we have total output Q. Then in the next column we have fixed cost TFC, variable cost, then total cost, average fixed cost, average variable cost, average total cost or average cost, and marginal cost. Now we all know these all concepts. Marginal cost means one extra unit, if it is produced, how much it shall cost. So now first, for total output, if it is 0, total fixed cost is 300, variable cost is 0. So total cost shall be 300. There shall be no average variable, no other cost. Then next is, when one unit is produced, total fixed cost will still remains 300. Then total variable cost goes to 60. So 360. So average fixed cost shall be 300. Average variable cost shall be 360. Then average total cost shall be 360. And marginal cost, that is cost of one additional unit, shall be 60. Then in the same case, if we have 2 output units, then the total fixed cost shall remain the same. So if for earlier it was 60, now it has come to 110. As the units increase, the cost shall decrease by some amount. So it comes to around 110. So the total shall be 410. So 150 shall be the average fixed cost, and 55 shall be variable cost, 205, and 50 shall be the marginal cost for the increased product, that is one additional unit which we introduce or which we produce further. So similarly, we can see how cost goes on. As the product goes on increasing, total fixed cost remains constant. Total variable cost goes on changing because we are introducing new additional units. So total cost also shall change, average cost shall change, and we shall understand that marginal cost, in case we are increasing one item, the cost shall go on increasing. So this is how till 9 units we have seen how cost goes on increasing and how there is a change. So now let us try to understand this with a curve. behavior of TC, TFC and TVC. Considering the above table 1.1, it can be seen that TFC remain constant at all levels of output, that is, FCs are independent of output. Means what? That fixed costs are independent without output. Then TVC varies directly with level of output. When output is 0, TVC is also 0. Up to output level 4, TVC increases at a decreasing rate. Beyond that output rate, TVC increases at an increasing rate. This characteristic of TVC function results from the operation of the law of diminishing marginal returns. A small output rate increases in its utilization of variable inputs may bring about increase in the productivity, causing TVC to increase with output but at an decreasing rate. Beyond the point, however, there are diminishing marginal returns from the variable input, with the result that TVCs increase at an increasing rate. So therefore we can understand that TC is equal to TFC, that is, total cost is equal to total fixed cost plus total variable cost. Change in total cost is entirely due to change in TVC, total variable cost. Since there are no changes in total fixed cost, all this can be diagrammatically represented as follows. So in the diagram we can see how total cost is remaining constant, total variable cost keeps on changing, total fixed cost remains same throughout the period. So this is the output curve which can be represented. So I hope you have understood this. Now let us start with TC, TFC and TVC. In the above figure 1.1, it can be seen that TFC is a straight horizontal line parallel to the x-axis. This TVC begins from origin, initially rises gradually but eventually becomes steeper because the total variable cost rises rapidly as output increases. So we can see how the total variable cost curve changes, total cost changes, fixed cost has remained same throughout the period. TC, total cost, is derived by the vertical addition of the total fixed cost and total variable cost. It takes the same shape as total variable cost. When total variable cost changes its rate of change, TC also changes in the same manner. So now we have tried to understand how this curve changes, and we have tried to understand the behavior of total cost, total fixed cost and total variable cost. So now let us move ahead with the average fixed cost. Now what is average fixed cost? Average fixed cost means per unit of output. Hence average fixed cost is equal to total fixed cost upon Q, that is, total fixed cost upon total units of output. Since total fixed cost is constant, AFC, that is, average fixed cost, will steadily fall as output increases. Therefore, average fixed cost curve slopes downward throughout its length. As output increases, the total fixed cost spreads over more and more units, and therefore average fixed cost becomes less and less when the when Q becomes very large, AFC approaches zero but not equal to zero. AFC has the shape of a rectangular hyperbola, refer in figure 1.2. So now we have studied in figure 1.1 about their total cost, total fixed cost and total variable cost. Now in the total average cost, that is, average fixed cost, we are seeing that as the number of units go on increasing, the total fixed cost, that is, the total fixed cost remains constant and total average cost keeps on changing. So we shall be seeing about it in figure 1.2. Then next we have average variable cost, AVC. Average variable cost means cost per unit of output. Average variable cost is equal to average variable total variable cost upon total units of output. Initially, average variable cost will decline due to increasing returns, reaches a minimum point C, and later will rise steeply due to the law of diminishing returns. Therefore, ABC is U-shaped, figure 1.2. So, in figure 1.2, let us understand, see, in figure 1.2, they have shown average cost, then average variable cost and average fixed cost. How these have kept on changing with different output units. So now, after this, let us try to understand about average total cost, that is ATC or average cost AC. This is the total cost per unit of output. Hence, average total cost is equal to total cost upon Q. Then, total fixed cost plus total variable cost upon Q is equal to total fixed cost upon Q plus total variable cost upon Q is equal to AFCE plus average fixed cost plus average variable cost. Now, the ATC is also U-shaped. This is because of the fact that ATC is the sum of AFC and ABC. As output increases, both AFC and ABC decrease. Hence, ATC must also decrease. But beyond some point, ATC must increase because increase in ABC eventually more than offset decreases in AFC. However, ATC achieves its minimum point B after ABC becomes because the increase in ABC are for a time more than offset by decreases in AFC. Refer figure 1.2. So, with this we can understand that total fixed cost and average total cost is a U-shaped figure which comes in figure 1.2. See, this shows a ABC, this shows a curve, a U-shaped curve, which is average variable cost. Then we want to see AC. Now how AC comes? See this AC curve. The reason for U-shape of the short run average cost SAC, the AC curve in the short run SAC has a pronounced U-shape. In the short run, the plant of the firm is fixed while other inputs are variable. Production is subject to the law of variable proportion. As output is increased to approach the capacity or optimum output of the plant, overhead cost per unit continue to fall. Till output reaches the capacity of the plant, in other inputs are lower in proportion than what the optimum proportions are in relation to the fixed plant, average cost will continue to fall. After the capacity output is reached, average cost begins to rise because the variable inputs become too much for the plant of fixed size. Thus, the U-shape of the average average cost curve is due to the non-proportional returns at a given scale of output. The non-proportional returns can in turn be explained by the technical reasons that underlie increasing returns to the variable input factors at first and then diminishing returns to them. Once the capacity output of the plant is exceeded. So this was about average total cost or average cost. So how is average total cost removed by the business firms, or how they try to give cost to different products? This was about average total cost. Now in the next class I shall be starting with the marginal cost, that is how marginal cost is considered and what all is done in that case. So I hope you have understood. Go through the lecture once again.